Let us discuss concepts of physics, textbook questions, objective question. First two questions here. A vector is not changed if. Generally, vector can be represented by both magnitude and direction. If either magnitude changes or direction changes or both magnitude and direction changes, then vector set to changes. First options here, it is rotated through an arbitrary angle. Suppose let us take this is the vector, in this direction is there. If this vector is rotated by this angle, this much angle, then direction changes so that vector is changes. And vector is multiplied by an arbitrary scalar. Let us assume a vector, velocity vector is equal to 2 meter per second, like that we assume. If you multiply this vector divided by certain number 4, then you multiply by 4 means magnitude changes. So magnitude changes so that vector will be changes. And it is cross multiplied by a unit vector. When we multiply a vector by another vector, then resultant vector is, if it is resultant is a vector, that is known as cross multiplication, then vector, resultant vector will be perpendicular to both the vectors, so that vector direction will be changes. Last options here, it is slide parallel to itself. When the vector is slide parallel to itself, magnitude do not change, direction also do not change, so that when vector is slid parallel to itself, then magnitude and direction do not change, so that vector is not changed. So for this question, D option is correct. Let us discuss second question. Which of the sets given below may represent the magnitude of three vectors adding to zero? When we add three vectors to get resultant zero, let us take any two of the vectors. Let us assume first vector is A vector, second vector is B vector. The resultant of A vector and B vector must be equal and opposite to the third vector, then resultant will be equilibrium. Equilibrium means total vectors will be zero. That means the resultant vector, third vector, should lie greater than or equal to directly subtraction of two vectors, or less than or equal to addition of two vectors. That means resultant of two vector whose minimum value is difference of two vectors, whose maximum value is addition of two vectors. If third vector lies between difference of two vectors and maximum of two vector, addition of two vector, then those three vectors will be in equilibrium. Let us take in first option two vectors here, maximum value is 6, but 8 is greater than 6 is there, so that it cannot be in equilibrium. Second options here, 4 and 8, maximum vector is 12, 4 and 8 if you add 12, but 16 is greater than 12. Let us take third option, maximum is 3, but minimum is 1. So this one, third vector lies between minimum and maximum. That means third vector equal to minimum is there, so that this option can be added. When we add these three vector, it can be 0. Fourth vector, these two vector, when we add, maximum is 1.5, minimum is 0.5. So 2 is not lies between maximum and minimum, so that fourth one cannot be in equilibrium. Similarly, once again, listen here, first options here, 2 and 4, if you take, the minimum is 2, maximum is 6, 8 do not lie between minimum and maximum. Second option, 4 and 8, if you take, minimum is 4, maximum is 12, 16 do not lie between minimum and maximum. Third vector only lies, what is that? First, this minimum of 1 and 2 is 1, maximum of 1 and 2 is 3. So this third vector lies in the minimum and maximum, 1 is there, so that third option only, this third option only gives a resultant vector adding all these vector is 0. Let us discuss third questions here. The resultant of A bar and B bar makes an angle alpha with A bar and beta with B bar. Listen here, two vectors are given to you. This is the A bar is given and this vector is B bar is given. Now let us take, this is the resultant vector. This resultant vector makes angle with A bar is alpha angle and B bar is beta angle is there. We know that resultant will lie near to the greatest vector. That means resultant lie near to the greatest vector means angle made will be lower. That means if A bar greater than B bar, then alpha angle should be less than angle beta. Like that options here, alpha less than beta means A bar is greater than B bar. A bar greater than B bar. Magnitude of A greater than magnitude of B. So for this question, option is C option. Third option is correct. Fourth question lesson here. The component of a vector is. The component of a vector is. Let us take certain vector. This is the A vector like that we assume. Whose x component and y component let us take. This is the x component and this is y component we assume. Suppose if you take here angle theta, then ax is equal to a cos theta. Ax is equal to a cos theta. Ay is equal to a sin theta. Ax is equal to a cos theta. Ay equal to a sin theta. Anyway, cos theta, we know that less than or equal to 1. Cos theta is less than or equal to 1. Sin theta is less than or equal to 1. And greater than or equal to minus 1. Greater than or equal to minus 1. So that here ax is there. Now this ax surely is greater than or equal to minus a, less than or equal to a. Similar way, ay also is greater than or equal to minus a, less than or equal to a, like that is there. That means the component of a vector may be equal to vector also, otherwise less than vector. So component of vector either less than vector, otherwise equal to vector. So equal to, always equal to cannot come, always less than cannot come, always greater than will not come. So none of these. For fourth question, option is none of this, because component of a vector may be equal to a vector or less than a vector. Fifth question, a vector a bar points vertically upward and b bar points towards north. The vector product of a bar cross b bar is. Vector product of a bar cross b bar is. So here let us take, this is the north direction and this is east direction. This is south direction and this is west direction, let us take. And here A bar is given vertically upward. A bar is given vertically upward. Let us take A bar is vertically upward. And B bar is along north is given. B bar is north is given. That means A bar and B bar are perpendicular. A bar and B bar are perpendicular. Let us take right-handed system. A bar cross B bar. A bar cross B bar will give. A bar cross B bar will give in west direction. So A bar cross B bar. A bar cross B bar gives in west direction. So that for fifth question, A bar cross B bar lie along west direction. So for fifth question, option A is correct. The radius of a circle is stated as 2.12 centimeter. Its area should be written as. Its area should be written as. Actually, we know the formula for area of the circle. Area of the circle is equal to pi r square. So here pi, we know that 3.141 into r value, we know that 2.12 is given. 2.12 into 2.12, since here r square is given. When we multiply the numbers, the resultant significance should be, the resultant significance should be least significant among the physical quantities which are multiplied. Here least significant, how much in this area is there, means 1, 2, 3 significant should is there. So answer, when we multiply the numbers, answer should come in the least significant among the given physical quantities which we multiplied. So here least significant is 3 significant is there, so that answer also should be in least significance. Here in first question 2 significant, second option 3 significant, fourth option 4 significant. Here fourth option, here six significant is there. That means first option 2 significant, second option 3 significant, third option 4 significant, and fourth option 6 significant is there. We should get resultant is 3 significant. So 3 significant is there in second option only. So for sixth question, option second option is correct answer.